Selling state assets will make our economy worse, according to a new report commissioned by the Green Party. Both the Greens and Labor are hammering Thursday's zero budget, saying it's proof the government has failing. We'll go live to One News political editor Corin Dan shortly for more on the budget. First, here's political reporter Michael Parkin.
Russell Norman casts a long shadow, but it's that of the zero budget he's concerned about.
Whether it's an increase in prescription charges, whether it's larger class sizes, less affordable housing, the poor decisions of the government on the budget put it into a hole and ordinary New Zealanders have to pay the price.
The government is touting the partial sale of state assets as a way to dig ourselves out of debt. Now, following protests and petitions, the Greens have called in economic analysts to tear apart the partial float, stressing the impact of letting shares in four power companies and Air New Zealand end up in foreign hands.
External debt is just plain bad. External debt is going to the loan shark.
The government says selling shares will raise between $5 to $7 billion, which will be invested in other assets like schools and irrigation. But Burl says there's a better way.
There's $100 billion of term deposits that our mom and pop investors have in trading banks in New Zealand. Why not get some of them to lend directly to government?
We asked the Treasury to provide us advice. They provided us advice that supported the mixed ownership model, and I'm much more of a mind to accept the Treasury advice than I would be of basically Burl's.
Labor's also on the attack in the lead up to Thursday's budget.
A zero budget is not something to boast about. A zero budget is an admission more of failure. A zero budget means zero growth.
But the Prime Minister says this is the responsible path. Michael Parkin, One News.